Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back to thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty.
James Thomas is here to tell it like it is. Here to talk education, politics, business. James is here for real talk without the yelling. Real issues and solutions. This is Tell It Like It Is with James Thomas on 1300 WTLS and 106.5 FM. Online at 1300WTLS.com.
Welcome to Tell It Like It Is. I'm your host, James Thomas, and I have a very special guest. First appearance on Tell It Like It Is, and that's Chaplain John Bailey. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
You know, it's the first time you're the second man of the cloth I've ever had on the show. First was Maggie Street Baptist Church. Mm-hmm. So I'm actually glad that you're here.
Well, good to be here.
Great. And, you know, before we go in, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I've been with Central Alabama VA healthcare system since 2013. Okay. Transferred in from Tuscaloosa VA Medical Center, where I was the chief. And since being here, I've also transferred. I'm also an Air National Guard chaplain, okay, where I serve here locally in Montgomery at the 187 Fighter Wing.
Right off of next to the Montgomery
Field,
Airport.
Yes, to the airport. So I kind of manage two programs, both military and the Veteran Affairs, so able to interact with them while they're on active, right, and then when they make that transition. So it's been great being able to kind of manage two hats, right, you want to say.
Now, before we go into a lot of the services, tell us about the Chaplain Corps, the VA Chaplain Corps, because I don't think a lot of vets know we have a Chaplain Corps.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Well, the Chaplain Corps for the Veteran Healthcare System really have two main purposes. One is to provide religious services for our veterans, their right to free exercise of religion while they're veterans.
Right.
And then two is to protect them from those that may come in proselytizing. And so those are the two main missions of chaplains. And so in that entails a lot.
Right. True.
Providing worship services on Sundays for those that want to go to a chapel service, especially in Tuskegee area where our largest population of veterans are located. We have worship services at 9 o'clock that begin every Sunday, as well as inpatient units where we also provide services on the units for those veterans that can't go out. So they can exercise their right to religious, their religious freedom rights.
You know, one of the things, I take advantages of the services. I know the free Bibles.
Absolutely.
And I love the daily update or the daily readings.
Uh-huh.
And I literally make sure I get one every year. And I love reading that book. I really do.
Absolutely.
But the services, you guys, now you don't just pass out King James Versions, which kind of surprised me because I noticed you also pass out the Quran.
We do. We provide for
all religious
services. If we're not able to provide, then we're able to refer, which is part of providing their religious right. So we usually have a great relationship with the local imam, the Jewish rabbis,
wow,
and all of those different faith groups. If we're not able to facilitate, we are able to refer.
Right. Now, one thing that really caught my eye that you got services you guys provide that I wasn't aware of, and that's this couples retreat or weekend retreat. Tell us about that.
Oh, absolutely. We do a retreat that really focuses on the veterans that are struggling with PTSD,
okay,
or trying to reconnect after being deployed numerous times. And it's called Practical Application in Intimate Relationships. And it's a curriculum that was found proven probably early on, right after 9/11. It was very proven that maybe 90% or more of the veterans that attended this actual workshop that provided a communication skill, provided emotional literacy, and of course the VA would actually provide the cost of the room, cost of the food, and provide 3 days of intense communication good. And relationship.
Where is this? And this is like a part of a ongoing treatment.
It's an ongoing thing. We usually do them every year, where we will find a location throughout Alabama. Maybe like we do one in North Alabama, one in South. So veterans all across
all
the state
across can take advantage.
Can take advantage.
Wow, that's a beautiful service. Now you have what we're here for is we want to talk about remembering American Heroes. It's an event that's coming up May 5th, and it's going to be held at the Tuskegee campus?
Yes, at the Tuskegee campus.
Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, we do a memorial biannually. We usually do it twice a year in May, in the month of May, which is Memorial Day, and also in November, which is Veterans Day. And so remember veterans that have transitioned or that have been patients at Central Alabama, and so it's sort of our way of honoring as well as providing a relationship with the widow, which is part of our mission to serve the widow, and we present them with a certificate saying thank them for their service and that we're still here to be a part of the grieving process after they have transitioned, and really just keep positive relationships as they transition from the VA and that last journey on this side.
Right. Mm-hmm. Now, notice there's going to be a motorcycle parade.
Yes.
By the Capital City Rough Riders.
Yes.
They sound rough.
They are. We did our first one our last event, which was in November, and there was a group of motorcycles, probably about 30 of them, that came in, and symbolic of the transition, that veterans journey on this side, and so they came in around the chapel and transitioned around to the CLC, and which is right behind the chapel, and where all of our inpatients are, and they just did a little parade a couple of times, and veterans were sitting outside.
That is beautiful.
Very, very powerful. In fact, one of the Rough Riders is a lab technician that volunteered to.
That's great.
Volunteered to be a part of it.
You'll be surprised. A lot of motorcycle gangs or groups are veterans.
And they were veterans.
You know, a lot, when I look back at the history of how the Hells Angels started, when I was in law enforcement, I was amazed. It started by three guys who actually were veterans that came from Vietnam veterans, and they were disgusted with the way they were being Vietnam vets were being treated when they came home, and literally started. At first, it was just free willing to being able to ride free, and of course, over time, the Hells Angels got bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, and one of the most feared motorcycle gangs in the nation, actually the world, really. Mm-hmm. And, but it really started by Vietnam veterans who was disgusted with how they were being treated when they came home.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, as rank is ascended, you know, the mission was changed from what they originally started. Mm-hmm. But I really applaud seeing a lot of motorcycle groups try to help veterans, and I noticed that when they come, they do come strong.
Yes.
I noticed the bike the bike drive that the VA had. Those guys were right there. We participated in a couple of the bike drives, and the motorcycle groups really just for some reason just they make it stand out even more, you know, I guess. But that is great. Mm-hmm. You guys, how long When you were in, you just came in 2013, was it to Alabama or was it to Just to this market?
Just to here. I was in Tuscaloosa. Okay. At the IVA there for about 5 years.
Now, if someone, what does it take to be a chaplain within the VA chaplain corps?
To be a chaplain in the VA, you have to have your master's, at least 72 hours of religious studies, or a 90-hour MDiv, or Master's of Divinity. Okay. You have to have a master's degree, and you have to have at least 2 units of clinical pastoral education, which is a supervised clinical pastoral hospital experience under a certified instructor, as well as be endorsed by a major faith group.
Right.
That will endorse you to be able to do sermons, funerals, and weddings. So those are the main criteria to be a chaplain.
I noticed you guys have a community clergy training program. Let's talk about that for a minute. Mm-hmm. It's coming April 20th. It's going to be held. Is it two or is the same one going to be held at this one at the Red Cross?
This is a this is a community clergy training program that that actually will it kind of started a few years ago. It's probably maybe 2008,
right?
Where as veterans were returning for combat, a research was done that said that out of half of those veterans that come, maybe 5 out of 10 veterans that return from combat and have post-traumatic stress or whatever disorders or suffering from combat, right, they're going to turn to their local clergy person.
True.
Before they return to a mental health provider.
I believe that.
And so we started doing these probably about 10 years ago into the congregation because of those numbers.
Right.
And so now we've developed this program called a community clergy training program, where we actually work with local clergy, community lay leaders, anybody that wants to be a partner with the Veteran Affairs.
So this is basically not necessarily a clergy from the VA. This is for outside.
This is for outside.
Correct. Oh, great, great.
It was designed to really reach the rural areas, yeah, because the rural areas didn't have as much access to care, especially mental health providers.
Right.
And so a returning warrior may turn to a small church pastor to say, right, hey, I'm experiencing some difficulty, or maybe a family member that would say, hey, pastor, my spouse isn't the same since they returned from combat.
Right.
And so that's kind of what it was designed to do, and reach those rural areas to provide and equip and educate clergy, right, on how to help veterans.
Oh, great. Mm-hmm. You know, this is something that's very much needed.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. So, again, this is a community clergy training program helping veterans access care and resources. This training is going to be held April 20th. At the American Red Cross, located at 5015 Wood Crossing, right here in Montgomery. Again, that's 5015 Wood Crossing. I will have more information on this on our station website, as well as talktoalabama.com. And we're going to keep throughout the day and up until April 20th, we're going to keep this information being passed out to the community. So please take advantage of the clergy training program that's going to be held April 20th. At the American Red Cross. Now, and this is for anybody, any denomination, person of the cloth that is interested in being able to help veterans, mm-hmm, that are suffering from whether it be PTSD, family related mm-hmm issues. So what type of curriculum or training do you provide these guys? Do they receive a certificate when they're done?
They do. They receive 3 contact hours.
Okay.
And right now we have 4 modules that were recorded. It was live probably back in 2014.
Right.
That was recorded present and allow to facilitate discussion amongst clergy.
Right.
So module 1 is military culture and wounds of war, to provide education on military culture, wounds, right, of war. Module 2 is providing pastoral care, how to provide pastoral care and really talk about moral injuries,
right,
that veterans may be suffering from. And 3 is on mental health and how to make referrals and,
right,
and providing a face and a personal contact to clergy with who their local chaplains are. And then four is how to build community partnerships.
Right.
And so, which is kind of the ultimate goal, is that after the fourth, we hope that, you know, people will begin to develop partnerships, which we do have a partnership
right.
now that has formed out of the Red Cross by a young lady by the name of Brenda Cherry,
yes.
who has formed up a community clergy partnership, and they meet on a monthly basis.
Wow.
And they create their own mission and vision of what do we want to do to help veterans in our community.
Right. Mm-hmm. Oh, that is very beautiful. Now, we also have, man, the VA has got a lot of things going on. Now, again, you know, I didn't mention, for the community clergy training program is held from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. Again, that's April 20th from 1 to 4 p.m. at the American Red Cross at 5015 Wood Crossing Drive on right here in Montgomery.
Mm-hmm.
The same date, Friday, April 20th, they are holding a Veterans Town Hall meeting in Brundage, Alabama, and it's going to be at the Robert E. Burr Nutrition Center from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. Town halls is a lot different. That's more or less where a lot of VAs, veterans can go and just, I guess, voice their concerns.
Right. To the director.
Okay.
And to the leadership.
So basically, the director and members of the executive leadership team will be there, and they have an opportunity. So that Veterans Town Hall meeting will be held again Friday, April 20th from 2 p.m. to 3:30 in Brundage, Alabama at the Robert E. Barr Nutrition Center, 107 Brundage Station Drive. So more information, I will have all this information on our website on talktoalabama.com, as well as 1300WTLS.com. We will also have announcements going out, public service announcements letting you know about these events as well. So please take advantage of this event. And Pastor Bailey, I would like for you to actually go on a station in Selma, WBRZ. I work mm-hmm. with those guys a lot. Because that's a rural area that we have a lot of veterans.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know, do you have a lot of participation from that type of area? I'm talking about Perry County, Wilcox County, Marion Junction, Selma. Do you have clergy from that area that participates in this?
Some, yes, we do. In fact, I did an event in Selma.
Oh, okay.
At Wallace College.
Wallace, right.
It's probably been a few years now since I've done that. But,
okay.
Had a great relationship with the pastor of one of the mega churches there, as well as the current mayor before we became mayor, that we worked to do community clergy training at the college.
Okay, yes, okay. Yeah, Dario Melton. Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
matter of fact, he is in the... he's definitely a medical.
Mm-hmm. Yes, he is.
Definitely. So, again, we're talking about remembering American heroes. How did this come about?
This came about, I guess it's been something that we've been doing now ever since I arrived.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been going on probably for some time before that, where usually we have a memorial service for all the veterans that,
right.
that have transitioned. And since I've been here, we did one a year. But because we had such a high turnover with that age group, that we're starting to do them twice a year now.
Right.
And we're now also opening it up to anyone. So anyone that has had a veteran that has died, even to be not even at our facility, but just know a veteran, that we will actually honor them and add them to the name. We'll do a roll call of
right.
all veterans, symbolic of their military. You know,
exactly.
Roll
exactly.
call. So we do the roll call, we do playing of taps, and then we present them with a really, really nice certificate, so there's some sort of connection, you
right.
know,
true.
A closure, I guess you want to say, a closure for the veteran and their care in the VA.
Now, this is being held May 5th at 11 a.m., Building 93 in Tuskegee.
Mm-hmm.
So the Central Alabama Veterans Healthcare System will hold this biannual memorial service, which is Remembering America's Heroes,
mm-hmm.
May 5th at 11 o'clock, Building 93 in Tuskegee. So please take advantage. Do they have to sign up or RSVP for this? Or they just show
yes.
up?
They can just show up, but it'd be good if they would RSVP. That way we can make sure we have
mm-hmm. it. The chaplain corps did not utilized that. You know, it was really a more personable type of thing, and I really respect and admire that from the Chaplain Corps, and I've always enjoyed my interactions with them. So I want to thank you for what you guys do and for the services you guys provide. And you know, anytime or any way that WTLS or any of our other sister radio stations that we partner with can help you, please don't hesitate to call.
Thank you, thank you.
John, I want to thank you for being on the show.
Thank you, for having me.
If you have anything else you would like to let our audience know?
No, just other than reach out to those numbers that you provided, and we'll definitely get their names, family member names, and get them a certificate for this upcoming memorial service.
Mm-hmm. Again, that's Remembering American Heroes. It's an event that's going to be held May 5th at Tuskegee Building 93. It starts at 11 o'clock. And then before that, we have the clergy training program, which is being held April 20th. It's going to be held at the American Red Cross Building right here in Montgomery. So please take advantage of that. And also the town hall meeting that's going to be held the same day at 2 o'clock. And if I'm not mistaken, Brundage is it's a beautiful drive. So if you can take advantage, don't have to be just from the residents of the Brundage area. Can be from the surrounding area as well. So here's an opportunity for you to meet with the leadership of the VA and voice your concerns. I know a lot of veterans contact myself and they tell me some of their concerns, which I'm able to provide as through their PAO office. But I really, again, I have a great deal of respect for the Veterans Chaplain Corps and you guys. You know, I've met a few people that utilize your services, and there's nothing but great respect for what you guys do. So again, on anything that we could do to help you guys get the word out for what services that you're offering, don't hesitate to call us. I want to thank Country Inn and Suites for providing us with the opportunity to broadcast here. We're broadcasting live right here at Country Inn and Suites, located on Chantilly Parkway. For those who are viewing us live on talktoalabama.com and listening to us on 1300 AM and 106.5 FM, thank you, and we'll talk to you next week. Take care.